I hope that this is now one of the final modes also that you're going to see, because I guess in this mode we have everything. We let me just start. And so till now, the FollSeg that you have seen was kind of like a seed pooling approach where seeds come from stardist, seeds come from unet, and you had kind of no choice but to accept the seeds that were coming. And you had to do either watershed to expand the seeds, or you accept the stardist approximation of star convex cell shapes. So what I did now is to actually create some choices which give you more flexibility based upon your kind of images that you have. So for example, so right now I have preloaded a stardist model, and there's no unet in the denoising model at this point. And by default, there is a optimized thresholds JSON file from which it is reading these values. And now the new thing is in this panel where I have it added a choice of do seed pooling. If you say do seed pooling, and if you choose a unet or a denoising model, it will actually take the seeds from the semantic map it makes, either from the denoised image or from the unet segmented image, and then it adds it to the seed pool. But let's say if you even select a stardist, a care model, and you don't want to take extra seeds, you can uncheck do seed pooling. For this the simple case, if you just if you have something like this, for now it's kind of a bug, so doing this will actually make the run button available. It's just some kind of choice which I have to take care of more carefully. But if you hit run now, you are going to get the stardist results, which has which is only taking the raw image and not denoised image. And then FollSeg is going to take the seeds from the stardist, and instead of making a star convex approximation, it's just going to do the watershed. So in this particular mode, the stardist and the FollSeg results actually would look pretty much the same. And then I want to show you what is the difference if you use a denoising as a step before, because sometimes it could be helpful to separate overlapping objects which in non-denoised image appear as one. However, it's something which you have to see on your image if it really helps, because I will show you the results that come here if you don't use denoising and just go stardist or FollSeg, and then we will compare it with what happens if you do denoising and then you do stardist, but then you don't add extra seeds but only use the seeds coming from stardist and use them to do and this is coming from the denoising image. So one thing I changed was, before I was using otsu thresholding, assuming that there's a bimodal peaks in your histograms, but usually in these kind of images there is background and there are dark cells and there are bright cells, so it's kind of like you have a trimodal histogram. So internally I changed the threshold otsu to threshold otsu with multiple thresholds, but default value for the class is 3. So that's why your denoising image is now going to produce a better unet mask than before, right? Okay, so this is now including everything. So I'm going to just first see not this one, but just the stardist results. Okay, and this is for one time point. So it seems okay because cells are kind of nicely separated, like over here, this one. And even here, these two. And if I just turn on the FollSeg, it kind of looks the same. And now let's look at it in 3D. So there are like apparently 3 cells. Sometimes it's a bit better to view this in 3D, then you kind of can see easily how many cells it's actually finding. FollSeg also finds 3. Stardust takes 2. And here, you looks like 2, right? Yeah. And it's nice. Some maybe it's like we just increase the contrast a little bit to clearly see the cells. Seems like it works, right? Like I did extra training of Stardust also, and added a bit of data augmentation by creating the noised images, and now it is doing it nicely. And here, did it miss it or is it a color? Sometimes these colors can be deceptive. It could actually be just a brown color. See, it was actually segmented properly. And here, 1, 2, 3, 4. And FollSeg. It's kind of the same, but the shape is a bit different. Okay, and this looks a bit like, why is there 2? Is this really 2? Now this is the question. Since I only have this kind of blurry image, I cannot really decide. So now let's turn on the denoising model. And then I'm going to ask it to not do the seed pooling. It's only going to take the seeds from Stardust and expand it on the binary mask coming after doing the watersheding, coming after doing the denoising. And the thing about this denoising approach is that when you denoise your image, you still have pixels which have low values, right? When you denoise the image and you get the probability map, which is the base watershed map, you still have pixels like these ones, which would be a part of the probability map. So you would have to, I put like a hard code cutoff in the code of 0.2. So only the pixels whose value is above 0.2 will be actually included from the probability map to be a part of the binary mask, which is kind of a fair choice, because if you take this value to be too low, you get overflows of your watersheding regions. So now just wait for the results to be updated. So the important features updates here. Seed pooling is optional. The threshold otsu option is gone. Now it's been replaced by a threshold otsu with multiple thresholds, where default number of classes is 3. So that it assumes that you have a trimodal histogram for your intensity and you want to separate only the noise from the dark cells and the bright cells. So your dark cells and the bright cells will still remain in the image. And then when I'm making the unet mask, not from unet but from denoising, I have a threshold of 0.2 to produce that binary mask to avoid overflows of the segmentation. And so using this, you should be able to capture a lot of your cells properly, in the sense of one cell is segmented once and not twice, and two cells are segmented as 2 and not 1. And so you can get rid of, I hope that a lot of these mistakes go away. And then you should be able to track good amount of cells, not all, but focus on getting the good ones, the good tracks, and that will give you enough statistics given the number of cells that you have here. Okay. And the GUI is not frozen. So if I do this, don't display probability map, it should actually work. But now it's, the result is already there, so it's too late. But otherwise you could have toggled this visibility even when the calculation was running, and it would actually listen to it. Okay, so now let's see what is the difference between the denoised and the non-denoised results. So this is with denoising, and here still finds 2 cells. So apparently it's like somehow even in denoising it looks like 2 cells to him. Okay, start hardest. This is okay. This is nice. FollSeg. No extra seeds, but now just a different way of getting. So FollSeg and Stardust will differ in, like, Stardust is going to have this kind of a shape, so it will be kind of always over your cells, and FollSeg will actually stop at the boundary, so it will be kind of like inside. It will end up inside, start a bit maybe late here. In few Z's it will skip, and then it will have these kind of segmentations for these cells. And let's look at this one. Okay, it looks like an elongated cell. It looks like, okay, but it's like if Stardust finds it as one and we don't have any extra seed coming from the seed pool, you are always going to get only one cell, because this is the base image for the thresholding, for getting the watershedding. So watershedding is done on images like this, the probability maps, and here if there is only one marker like this one, it is going to cover the whole cell as one segmented cell. Here you will find 1, 2, and 3. You can see this. See, 1, 2, and 3. And FollSeg is also going to give you 1, 2, and 3. And some of the cells are really bad. You can't really do anything with them. So let's focus on the good ones. And then either this one or Stardust will be also fine. Like this ones. And here, 3. That's kind of nice. Maybe it could be a good idea that in the images, if it's possible to have a tissue which is surrounding them, so that you only track the cells in the tissue, or you create a region of interest, because you know cells in the interior are a bit better than the cells in the periphery, so you can exclude them. So these are the two modes that I've shown you, and there is a third mode which is unet, but unet is going to give you, and now if it's unet, I'm asking it to create the unet from the create the binary mask from the unet and not from the denoised image. But I'm again asking it not to do the seed pulling, because maybe unet will produce some seeds here which you will see in the markers, and I do not want them to spoil my segmentation, so I only consider these markers which are the good ones, and then I'm not going to add extra markers in the seed pool. If this setting works well for you, and then you can combine the setting with these other settings that I have shown you. You can combine it with using all three models. Now what's going to happen is it's going to denoise the image, it's going to apply unet segmentation, Stardust segmentation on the denoised image, and it's not going to add extra seeds from the unet of, or the binary mask that it creates. That's just for a mask image that it uses to do the watershed. And yeah, that gives you slightly different results than Stardust and if you didn't use unet at all. So I'm playing around with these kind of settings and seeing which one works best for the images at a given time point. And it's kind of hard still to make it work for all of them. So we have kind of no choice but to discard some cells like this from the tracking. Yeah, we can trash the tracks of such cells. So that would create some effort because it's like manual editing then. Or we can actually, in Napari, you can actually kill the labels of these cells by the flood. It's like there's a flood filling tool that you have. This one and this, I think. Oh, I thought it was working in 3D. Is it not? It's still not in 3D. Yeah, that makes it kind of difficult to get rid of these kind of segmented regions. So now let's just toggle this. Let's see Stardust and the markers. Because now the markers are also going to come from the unet seeds, but we are not using them to do anything. It's just to show you why in this particular setting I ignore extra seeds and I don't do the seed pooling, because that would have spoiled the segmentation. It would have added some seeds over here like I did before. I mean, this cell, this region looks nice. It's kind of crowded. The cells are touching. So if the cells are kind of nicely shaped, then it is okay with them. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cells. It's fine. Yeah, 2 seeds and it looks like 1. I mean, it could be because these seeds are in 3D, right? So it could be a seed which corresponds to a cell which starts in another plane and actually is not the same cell. That's why you have like these kind of seeds, 3 seeds. So it's nice to have this kind of view so you can move around to see where the seed is coming from and stuff. Okay, so now it's done. And now these are the results, which is coming from using the unet mask, and you are seeing only stardust. So stardust doesn't change, it's not affected by this. And apparently the markers were not too bad. So you could have actually used them in the seed pool. And then the FollSeg labels are like this. So now since the watershedding is done on the unet mask, you kind of have these kind of features. If the unet mask extends to these kind of things, it goes a bit more to capture the shape coming from the unit mask itself. So if you want this kind of shapes, that you get the exact shape of your cell, then you would use this setting. For example, let's look at this cell. So if I look at the denoised image of this cell, then FollSeg level. So the unit kind of produce these shapes. That's what I use unit for, to get these kind of shapes properly. But if your model isn't very well adapted or very well trained for the unit setting, then you can easily avoid this by using denoising or not using denoising also. And you always have this stardust results that you can rely on, which is nice in almost a lot of cases. Okay, so that's the thing I was playing with, and I got these settings, I got these new features, and now try this out. And my recommendation would be stardust and denoising with care, and then not using seed pooling. And this option will disappear if you have no unit clicked, then you cannot get a unit from the binary mask from the unit. So stardust and care, and then no seed pooling, probability map for watershed, and these values are optimized. And if you're getting over segmentation, you can actually reduce this number to 0.2 or 0.1, then it will not produce these kind of 2 cells, it will merge them into 1. But it seems okay for me, but you decide. Okay, let me know if this setting works well than before. Otherwise, I'll work on it more to see what we can do. Maybe we can really do a correction of some of these cells, like hardcore manual annotation or correcting the annotations, and then training a model which has seen a lot of these different cases. So we can always make our model strong. But if I'm saying that, okay, the model is like this much, it's at the limit, then we have these kind of additional mathematical things that we can do to make it as good as it can. See you. Ciao.